Hello soccer fans, my name is Juan Carlos Carreras. I was in FC Barcelona Academy for 7 years. I played professional soccer for 11 years. I played FC Barcelona a couple of times. In my opinion, it's important to say that I was a defender. I have all the possible soccer licenses in Europe. Finally, I have a special experience in the formative soccer as a coach and a technical director. I want to share my knowledge. Thank you. Hello soccer fans. Today I am going to speak to you about two topics: how to defend aerial balls and the two types of defensive star in soccer. I have separated the topic how to defend aerial balls into three parts. The defender quickly has to occupy the position where the ball will land. The defender has to jump earlier than the forward, blocking the forward's jump. And recommendation for small defenders. Before explaining the parts of how to defend aerial balls, I want to tell you a consideration. To win the aerial ball has relative importance. The first ball sometimes is challenging to win because there is a fight between forward and defender. A lot of time will be difficult for the defender who wins the first ball and perform a pass. In this play situation, winning the second ball is the most important. So, coaches generally organize plans for winning the second ball when the ball is coming by the air. How we can have success in the air ball fight? Physical quality, obviously, especially the health will help to have success. But there are other considerations that will also help us. First, the defenders quickly occupies the right position. Right position is the place where the ball is going to fall down. We will quickly position ourselves where the ball is going to land. We will not allow the opponent to win us the correct position. To position ourselves when the ball is going to fall down, it is very important to be focused on the ball and not on the opponent. A common mistake is to be more focused on the opponent than on the ball. Let's see it. The defender has to jump earlier than the forwards blocking the forward jump. Jumping a little before of opponent leaning on his body is going to help us for winning aerial balls too. With this, we will also prevent the correct and comfortable jump of the opponent. We can win the ball including whether the opponent is in a good position. Let's see it. Finally, recommendation for small defenders. Small players who should generally have little success in these actions can try the following. See quickly where the ball is going to land, observes where the body opponent is, and place your body in the way of the opponent toward the ball for two purposes. First, block the opponent to hit does not win the correct position. Second, be run over by the opponent and cause a foul in favor. I promise you that it worked well. I did it a lot of time in my soccer career. Next movie, we are going to see a mistake about it. Let's see it. The second topic of today is the two types of defensive turns. Long turns, we have to try to avoid it, and short turns, we have to try to do it. In other movies, we have spoken about the importance that time is in soccer. If you are able to do whatever defensive or offensive action in less time, you are going to have more chance to have success. Long term, I know that this moment appears a question. If we are spending more time in the long term, why do a lot of defenders perform it? The answer is because with the long term, the defender is always watching the ball. However, with the short term, the defenders are 1 second without knowing where the ball is. The defenders' regular teaching say that the defenders always have to see where the ball is. My recommendation is to practice and perform the short turns. In this action, in my opinion, it's more important to turn quicker than to see all the time the ball. Now we are going to watch a sample of long and short turns. Let's see it.
If you liked it, give me a like and to share it. If you want to receive more videos like this one, register. Thank you. I hope to see you soon.